Hi there, I'm Danielle.
And I'm Kalanch.
And we are first-time sailboat owners to Seabee, a beautiful 45-foot Elan sailboat that's currently berthed over in Croatia. About 5 to 6 years ago, Kalanch and I put ourselves on a pretty aggressive plan to start saving our pennies, doing a ton of boat research, so that one day we could afford to buy a boat, quit our jobs, and start sailing the world. Well, everything was coming together perfectly according to our plan and timeline. We finally found the right boat for us in January 2020, and our intention was to start sailing shortly afterwards. Well, then we hit an unexpected delay, and that, of course, was due to COVID and the worldwide pandemic. So for the last year, we've been waiting things out at our home here in the Bay Area, California. But we're excited to say we finally have a new departure date coming up pretty soon, and that's going to be in March 2021.
Yeah, the sailing plan and the type of sailboat we wanted evolved over the years. Our original plan was to go under the Golden Gate Bridge into the mercy of Pacific Ocean, turn left, go to Mexico, maybe cross an ocean, go to French Polynesia. For that, we thought we will need a heavy displacement blue water cruiser. But what happened over the years was we did a number of charters in Caribbean and Mediterranean, and we got exposed to the benefits of what a modern, well-designed, well-built, well-engineered cruiser may offer. So our focus shifted, and as we start doing our research, we immediately realized the pricing and the inventory was more advantageous in Europe than anywhere else in the world. As we were doing our research, one specific boat caught our attention, that was the Elan Impression 45. So that doing the research and reading the blogs was the easy part. The next step was to go to Europe and see a number of these boats in person, which is what I exactly did in February and January timeframe in 2020. And in this upcoming video, I'm going to share my experience with boat shopping in Croatia.
Here at the San Francisco International Airport, it's January 18, 2020. The plan is to fly to Croatia and hopefully buy a sailboat.
After a long travel day, I finally arrived in Split. I was so focused in my boat research, I had no idea what to expect from the city. Split is an unexpected treat. Although I'm super stoked to explore this charming city, I don't have a lot of time for sightseeing. I'm gonna be staying in Split for the next 3 days, and I have a number of boats lined up for tomorrow and the following day. In my first day of boat shopping, I have 3 appointments lined up in Marina Kremik. Marina Kremik is located about an hour and a half north of Split, near a historic town called Primosti. Boat number one is a 2015 Elan Impression 45. She has been in charter since new and has about 2,000 engine hours. At first sight, what stood out was the teak deck upgrade, which you don't typically see on boats in a charter fleet. She comes with a small size swimming platform instead of a popular larger swimming platform. Although I like the idea of having a teak deck, I'm not sure I want to sign up for the maintenance work that comes with it. Condition of the exterior seemed decent without any signs of obvious damage or major repairs. This Impression 45 comes with 4 cabin configuration, which is the most popular configuration among charter fleets. In addition to the 2 aft cabins, you have a forward cabin and a cabin on the port with small size bunk beds. Although it wasn't horrible, this 2015 Elan Impression showed signs of wear and tear of being in charter for the last 5 years. Boat number 2 is a 2016 Elan Impression 40. She's been in charter for the last 4 years and comes with about 1300 engine hours. She is a small version of Elan Impression 45. Since we plan on living on the boat, I'm not sure if the 40-foot version is going to be sufficient enough for us. You can see the size of the swimming platform compared to the swimming platform we just saw on the other boat. Compared to the earlier example, this boat has been in charter for 4 seasons instead of 5. Charter boats in this part of the world generally logs 400 to 500 hours each season. You can clearly tell the toll each charter season takes on these boats. Although she is in much better shape than the earlier example, I am afraid my concern about the size was valid. My last appointment in day one is a 2013 Elan Impression 444. This boat was my favorite on paper before I arrived to Croatia. The pictures looked great and she was reasonably priced. At first, she looked exactly the same as pictures. Little bit older than earlier examples, the hull, the exterior, and the deck looked like it was in really good shape.
interior looked also great, very clean and well kept. It was hard to believe that this boat has been in charter for the last 7 seasons. Impression 444 is a predecessor of Impression 45. Both boats share the same hull design and mold. And as you can see, the interior is almost identical. I was getting really excited about this boat, and for sure it will be part of our short list. But then I start noticing strange things, such as this. First, I thought maybe a quick fix, but how do you bend an anchor roller like that? Somebody must have hit something really hard. So I went back to the dock to take a closer look, and this is what I noticed. I also noticed the stern pulpit was bent, possibly as a result of another collision. But the icing on the cake was the falsely advertised engine hours. She had almost 3 times more hours than advertised. My first day was disappointing, where all 3 options missed the mark. My 2 appointments on day 2 are both located in the split. Instead of driving, I decided to hike to the other side of the town. Today's first boat is a 2015 Elan Impression 45. She's been in charter fleet her entire life, and she has about 2,000 engine hours on the clock. To my surprise, this boat was on dry dock, which gave me a perspective of below waterline hull structure of Elan 45 Impression for the first time. The large fuel and water tankage offered in these boats are one of the reasons that we were attracted to this modern cruiser. This particular example comes with the additional optional tank, which takes the water storage from 500 liters to almost 800 liters. The shrouds, the lifelines, stanchions, and the pulpits all felt solid. Overall, the condition of the boat seemed decent, considering that it had been chartered for 5 seasons.
And this will be repaired.
Here you see Adam, the yacht broker, pointing out cosmetic defects of the boat.
The top like this, which goes down, like a cover, and that is broken, they will also repair it.
Okay.
Bathrooms were free of odors, which is very common in charter boats. All the doors close and open easily and latched the way they should. The fridge and the freezer was also free of odors, another common issue in ex-charter boats. Overall, I thought this boat was a pass with minor cosmetic defects and one potential problem, and it's this. The keel showed signs of multiple groundings. These may be cosmetic, but Such groundings may also jeopardize the integrity of bolts that keep the hull and the keel intact. My last appointment, day two, is a 2014 Elan Impression 444. This is the last year Elan produced the 444 before moving into the Impression 45. What differentiates this particular vessel from what we've seen so far and what we're gonna see later is the fact that it comes with a regular full batten mainsail versus a furling main. She's been in charter fleet since new, and within the last 6 seasons, she put 2,200 engine hours on the clock. Unfortunately, she was not in any way, shape or form to be presented to a potential buyer. Things were all over the place and chaotic. There is no way that you can get a good or bad feeling about the condition of this vessel. What was most disturbing about this boat was the fact that they knew somebody was traveling across the globe to see this vessel, and they didn't do anything to make it at least somewhat presentable. I'm just glad I didn't put all my eggs in one basket. The silver lining in this situation was the fact that I get to see this boat in bare bones. In this particular boat, for the first time, I noticed this imperfect bulkhead joinery. I don't know what causes them, but if anybody knows, please do let me know. The second day was more encouraging than the first and presented one potential contender. Depending on what else to come tomorrow and the following day, I am prepared to extend an offer on 2015 Impression contingent upon marine survey. My only appointment in day 3 is a 2011 Elan Impression 444. She is located in Beograd. Beograd is a town in northern Dalmatia about 90 minutes north of Split, and is significant for being the former capital of medieval Croatian kingdom. With almost a decade in charter service and 4,500 hours on the clock, she looked extremely tired. In retrospect, I should have filmed and documented this boat to show her bad condition, but at the moment when I was there, I knew she would never be a contender. Although I was disappointed about the boat, the exciting thing about my Beograd trip was I get the chance to meet this great guy and his son in person. I met Boris on one of the online forums. Also an Elan owner living in Croatia, Boris was extremely helpful during our boat research and generously offered his time and deep knowledge relative to these boats. He was instrumental on our boat selection. One of the great things about sailing community is how fellow sailors go out of their way to help and share their knowledge with you. This is exactly what Boris did, which helped me immensely, plus I made a new friend.
My single appointment on day 3 was rather disappointing and missed the mark by widest margin.
So, today is my last day here in Croatia. I am on my way to Slano. I left Split early in the morning. The sun is not out yet, so I have about a 2.5 hour drive. There's a lot of tunnels in here.
My last appointment is a 2016 Elan Impression 45. She has been privately owned by her single owner since new. She only has about 600 hours on the engine, and you can quickly tell how lightly she's been used by just looking at the condition of the instruments. Moving forward, the mast fittings and the shroud attachments did not show any defects or stress cracks. Windlass, the roller and the anchor all looked in great condition. Anchor locker and the chain was clean and free of rust. The condition of the standing and running rigging was much better than other alternatives I have seen so far. I was pleasantly surprised by below decks condition. This is my second boat hunting trip to Europe, and I have stepped on probably more than a dozen boats. Some are privately owned, some are ex-chartered. I can confidently say that the condition of the interior was superior to any other used boat I have ever seen. The new boat smell was still there, and I felt like I was in one of those demo boats you see in boat shows. Another advantage about this particular vessel is she is US registered. As a US citizen, buying a US flag boat is much more straightforward than a foreign registered boat. Unlike the other examples so far, she comes with a very rare two cabin configuration. This configuration offers a spacey forward cabin with an in-suite head to the port and a separate shower room to starboard, which also can be used for wet locker or storage. She comes with a number of cruiser preferred options such as the extra water tank, the central robuster heater, radar, folding prop, and the electric head. But the best was yet to come, and that is the massive aft master cabin. An aft cabin this big is highly unusual on a cruiser at this size.
Overall, she felt and smelled like a new boat versus a used boat. Going through my checklist, I couldn't find a single defect. She was appropriately optioned for our needs, and she was younger than all other alternatives I have seen so far. The only challenge she presented was the fact that she was priced out of our budget. However, considering her superior condition, her age, and the options she came with, the upfront investment was a no-brainer. I really didn't need the long flight home next morning to contemplate. The decision was made before I stepped on the plane. She was the one. It's amazing that I find CB the last May in my Croatia trip. Although sometimes I felt like heartbroken and start losing hope, I really felt like I need to go through that process and see all these other alternatives to have a really good gauge on the condition and the cleanness of CB. The minute I stepped on CB, I knew it was the right boat. Upon my return to California, I didn't waste any time and I reached out to the seller, and we finalized the deal in February 2020.
It was a very exciting time indeed. Celebrations were had, lots of bubbles were poured. I even quit my job. Well, as we touched upon earlier, we did encounter the unexpected delay because of COVID. But finally, in September, Kavanch and I, we were able to make it back over to Croatia, along with Terry, who coincidentally is also from America, and he was the previous boat owner. So we met up with Terry in Croatia, which was very fortunate because it was one of the only European countries that were opening its borders to Americans. And together we did the sea trial and the boat survey and then finalized the deal. One of the other things that happened to Kavanch and I while we were on this trip to Croatia was just realizing what a beautiful country it is, and we didn't want to rush it. So we made the decision that we're going to spend our first year sailing extensively throughout Croatia. It has such a long, expansive coastline and numerous islands. It's truly a sailor's paradise. The other thing that happened to us while we had this extra year of waiting things out at home was we did some deep soul searching. And we realized instead of cutting things short and doing this adventure for 2 to 3 years, we're going all in for it. So at this point, we have no plans to return back to America. Kavanch and I are really open to anything and everything and all opportunities that might come up through our travels and sailing on CB.
Well, that's the new plan. I'm super excited. Consider subscribing to this channel so you don't miss episode number 2 when we depart from America and start our new adventure. You can also follow us at cbsailing.com. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Bye.